First up, though, a new documentary that takes a hard look at my profession, medicine. It's called Escape Fire, and it makes this controversial case. It says doctors focus too much on money, they do unnecessary procedures, they don't spend enough time on basic prevention. Case in point, a patient named Yvonne, diagnosed in her 30s with heart disease, who had bypass surgery, 27 cardiac catheterizations, and more than 7 stents implanted to keep her blood vessels open. Only then did she end up at the Cleveland Clinic, where doctors got her cholesterol and her blood pressure under control, and where they say counseling on diet and exercise helped Yvonne lose 20 pounds, all of it in an effort to try and avert more surgery.
I can't tell you how shocked we were when we saw her the first time, because here was a young woman whose diabetes was not well controlled, her cholesterol was never well controlled, and her high blood pressure was never well controlled.
Were you normally forming?
If someone had talked to her, I think someone had really teased out her chest pain and her shortness of breath, I think many of her cardiac catheterization and stents would not have been necessary.
Now, earlier I spoke with Dr. Steven Nissen, the chairman of cardiology at the Cleveland Clinic. He's featured in the film, and also with Dr. Jeffrey Marshall, a leading cardiologist whose specialty is implanting stents. Dr. Nissen, let me start with you. You say there's a lot of Yvonne's out there, the patient that we just met. A lot of unnecessary stents. You say they don't prevent heart attacks, they don't lengthen life.
The problem is, if you have stable chest pain, we have very good studies dating back a number of years that show that getting a stent will not prevent a heart attack and will not make you live longer. These are techniques that should be used to relieve symptoms. And some people, even that are getting stents, don't even have symptoms. They have a blockage that's not causing symptoms, and yet they're actually having a procedure.
Are a lot of these stents unnecessary?
I don't believe so. Actually, about 70% of all angioplasty and stent procedures in this country are done in people actively having heart attacks, okay? Large heart attacks or kind of smaller heart attacks, or having what we call unstable angina. That is chest pain that is actually currently damaging the heart in patients. So less than 30% are actually done in these people with stable ischemic heart disease.
We're 50% more likely to have a stent than we would in, say, countries in Western Europe where they have very similar disease rates. We're more likely to get a knee replacement or have a CAT scan or have an MRI. And that's because our system reimburses people for doing tests and doing procedures, not for necessarily making people healthier.
I think what Dr. Nissen's describing is a fee-for-service sort of model. You get paid for the service that you're doing as opposed to for the overall care of the patient. This is what you do for a living. Is that how you get paid? So if you have a patient comes in, you get paid a certain amount because you do a stent. Are you incentivized to do more stents?
Well, me personally, I'm on a salary.
So it doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter if I do one stent or 5 stents or 10 stents. My job is to provide the right care for the right patient at the right time.
So you're salaried.
Yes, sir.
Salaried too as a physician. And Dr. Nissen, you're salaried
yes.
as well.
Yes.
How big a problem is this then, these perverse incentives that you describe?
We're not saying that people are doing these procedures for profit. We're saying that the system has created incentives that in subtle and maybe not so subtle ways drives more procedures. If you get a bump on your head, as a friend of mine had, and you go into emergency department, in America, you get a CAT scan. Okay. If you have that happen in Germany or in England, they say, here's a list of instructions. If you have problems, come back and see us. We just spent $1,000.
Sometimes the patients demand this stuff.
Yes. But we have to educate patients.
I want to point out something. I think this is important because I think when people watch the film, they're left with the impression that Yvonne finally came to the Cleveland Clinic. She got her cholesterol under control, her weight under control, and things were great for her after that. But that's not the whole story. She ended up having another open heart operation, another bypass operation. I think that's an important point. It doesn't always work. I mean, the impression, I think, was a little bit misleading there. Don't you think, Dr. Nissen?
I do. Look, we can't prevent disease in everybody, but we have to try. The problem with Yvonne's case is she had all of those stents before she had the risk factors controlled. That's not good medicine. We have to teach young physicians that prevention comes first.
In the spirit of educating people out there, and again, I have cardiac disease in my family, who should absolutely get a stent?
So anybody that's having a heart attack should get a stent. It's the best treatment and it saves lives, period. Everybody agrees on that. The next group of people are people really that have tried medical therapy, that are on medical therapy, and they're failing. There are lots of people like that.
And you can see Escape Fire in its entirety, followed immediately by the rest of my discussion on rescuing the American healthcare system. That's Sunday night, 8 p.m. Eastern, right here on CNN.